I think my favorite piece of equipment on the boat is the Raymarine electric wheel pilot. The whole thing is a simple idea. It consists of a compass sensor down below decks along with a computer, a P70 control head, which I have mounted on the binnacle, and a small motor to turn the wheel. It operates pretty much like its predecessor, the SPX-5, which had 10 settings. This has 3. I think they're called leisure, cruising, and performance. These settings control the attention of the wheel pilot to the course, to what degree of hysteria it attempts to keep right on the number you have set. The leisure setting works best most of the time, I find, and it helps the little motor to relax and not spike in its amperage usage. We're going now to performance, and excuse me a minute, I don't really think there's any need to have a ship alarm here 4 miles off the coast of Malibu. So where were we? Oh, performance. Works about the same as cruising and leisure. On most boats with a wheel pilot installed, the skipper winds up steering by pushing buttons. And in fact, at the standard hard overtime setting of 6 seconds, that happens fairly slowly. It works well when actually sailing, but in harbor to dodge, say, a paddleboarder or a motorboat, you might want a faster turn. This is controlled, confusingly, by hard overtime, which you get to through a series best described by looking at the Raymarine manual. In true Raymarine mathematics, a longer hard overtime in seconds creates a faster turn. I don't know why they do it that way, but that's the way they do it. So if you take the hard overtime all the way up to, say, for example, 19, the rudder turns more quickly during a command than when set at 6 seconds of hard overtime. On the leisure setting, even with hard overtime set at 19, the boat's still controllable, although there's a little more action in the steering corrections than I think are necessary, and you can see the amperage spike every time the motor comes on, sometimes up to 4 amps, whereas it's usually under 2 by average. Now, so we don't go aground on the rocks here among Surf Rider Beach, we can jibe just by pushing the buttons. Looks like about 130 degrees is necessary, so I'll just push the starboard 10 button 13 times. And you know, when you're sailing alone, this can be quite useful, especially if you're trying to hold an iPhone in one hand while jibing, while keeping it focused on the instrument panel. A normal tack can be accomplished just by pushing the button 9 times at 10 degrees a button. And one real benefit of the higher settings on hard overtime is that things happen faster. You can head up by pushing the buttons quite quickly and head back down by just pushing the button the same number of times to port. With the initial factory setting of 6 on the hard overtime, all of this would take a minute or two, in fact. Now for me, this is still too active and hysterical, a series of corrections to be acceptable by a wheel pilot. So let's say the wheel pilots just don't work, everybody's right. Why, look at this, it's a simple day sailing in 12 knots on a broad reach, and the thing just doesn't work. Let's get rid of it. Or let's get rid of the skipper, because in fact the issue here is that the mainsail was not trimmed correctly, and by merely letting the mainsail out about 3 feet, the boat was balanced again, and the wheel pilot continued on sailing with more attention to the course than you or I ever could. I think it must be true that on most casual cruising boats out for a sail on a Sunday afternoon, very little attention is given to sail trim. And if a wheel pilot suddenly seems erratic, if the boat's slewing around this way and that, it's usually just a matter of letting the sails out until they luff and pulling them in a little bit more. Once the boat's balanced, it's easy for the wheel pilot. Why, there shouldn't be any muss nor fuss. A little quiet clicking in the cockpit on any point of sail. Thelonious II is 38 feet long and displaces more than 16,000 pounds, right at the upper limit of wheel pilot use. Even so, we can sail up to the first reef 17 or 18 knots. Beyond that, it's time to engage the vane steering gear, or turn on the powerful below decks autopilot, or just wake up your brother-in-law and tell him it's time for him to take the wheel.